What we're going to show you today is the properties, the soil and plant properties of infiltration and runoff. On the far left-hand side there, we have a cropland field soil that has been recently tilled. It's the same soil as the next soil, which is from an orchard. This soil in particular has some compaction issues, and it's covered in the type of cover that would normally look like this at this time of year. The third soil here in the middle is a rangeland soil. It's Bermuda or pasture, and it's very well aggregated, but not real compact soil. It's what would be considered a very healthy soil. This is a rangeland soil with a little bit of residue to simulate bare ground on rangeland. And then this is another rangeland soil with range grass. The heads aren't on it, but probably gaieta grass. And it shows partial cover. So what we want to do is simulate rainfall, and that's what these gauges are for. And then we're going to look at both infiltration and runoff, and then we'll discuss the differences. So what we're simulating here is more or less, we're going to put about an inch to an inch and a half, simulating a typical New Mexico summer rainfall event. Okay, let's talk about the results of what we see here. Now, very first thing you see, obviously, is the runoff in the front jars. And you can see the difference in runoff. Now, from our rangeland with partial cover, we have some runoff, some soil. From our rangeland with no cover, we have a lot of runoff and probably good siltation. We can get some with our fingers, not a lot. From our rangeland soil that is healthy, that has a lot of good cover, very little runoff. And what's there is not perfectly clear, but clearer than some of these others. From our compacted soil that's on orchard ground, we have runoff, maybe a little bit less than the same soil on a tilled ground. Now let's look at what the infiltration on the different soils are. Okay, so from this soil that ran off a lot, that's cultivated, we have very, very little, infiltration. In this soil that's compacted, also a little bit more because it's a perennial cover, so you're going to have a little bit more infiltration, but again, not as much. You have these, most of the water is in the runoff. Over here, with our healthy rangeland soil, what do we have here? We have a lot of infiltration. Very good infiltration, captured water. And we'll talk about that in a little bit. In this rangeland soil that has been not covered, it has bare ground, a little bit of infiltration, but not very much. And then again, we have partial cover, even just a partial cover on rangeland that's protecting against the rainfall. You could see that we have some good infiltration. So what we look for and what is important about this is the importance of keeping a good plant cover on the soil at all times. And that is particularly important in New Mexico when we have such strong rainstorms that come all at once. The soil needs to be healthy, it needs to be well aggregated, and it can only be that if it's in a healthy state. This is what we want to keep. We want to keep our water. We really don't want to be sending water off and in a runoff situation. Not only for supply of water, because we need to save and use our water to the best, especially here in the Southwest, but because when we send it down with sediments in it, it's contamination. It contaminates the streams. It could have pesticides in it, could have nutrients in it. By looking at the different soils, you'll be able to, once again, look at the soil health. Soil health is the ideal condition between the biological, physical, and chemical properties of the soil. And with good plant-soil relationships, we can achieve that.